The decision was a difficult one. It was arrived at carefully and respectfully by a process that began in January of this year and has been transparent, open, and fair.
Idiot. Ontario's Law Society says it will not allow graduates from the faith-based Trinity Western University to practice law in the province. And today, Nova Scotia followed that lead. The decisions are, well, they're a blow to the Christian school's plan to open a law school in 2016. Alberto's Paulos Agopoulos is a litigation lawyer, joins me in Ottawa. You know, I know it's not nice to yell idiot, but Alberto's, these are guys who are saying, let's make sure that we enforce, bring about diversity by enforcing uniformity. Help us walk through what this Trinity Western decision's all about. It's being portrayed as, you won't let kids have gay sex, so therefore you can't be allowed to be lawyers.
Right. Well, the issue with the opposition to Trinity Western revolves around their community covenant. So Trinity Western is a Christian university made up mostly of Christian students and Christian faculty. And what Trinity Western chose to do was develop, devise, and implement this community covenant.
Which, and it's not new, right? It's been around a long time?
It's been around a long time, and it's completely voluntary. So all the students do sign on to it, and one would think you go to Trinity Western because you want to sign on to it. And the community covenant has a lot of aspects to it, one of which is no sex outside the confines of a biblical marriage.
Meaning man and woman.
Meaning man and woman. So there's no gay sex rule, but there is a no sex outside of biblical marriage rule. And I use the word rule, it's an improper word because it's not a rule. As far as I understand it, this community covenant is not enforced. I suspect if you walk onto Trinity Western, there are people who are not acting in conformity with this community covenant, but they're not being expelled.
So, I mean, it's a faith-based school. This is almost a statement of faith. And along come the law societies as they are trying to establish a law school. And they say, no, because of this, you're not being diverse enough, so we won't allow you. That is diversity through uniformity.
I would agree. So the issue, again, is the law society is telling Trinity Western, you've met the academic standards because the government of British Columbia has accredited you. You meet the same academic standards as does the University of British Columbia or the University of Victoria, which both have law schools. The only reason that we don't like what you're doing, the only reason we will not recognize your law students is because of this faith-based community covenant, because you have a biblical view of marriage and sexuality.
So do they not see that they're being hypocrites in this? Do they not see that they are saying, you know, we accept diversity, but not your kind of diversity. We only want certain types.
I can't speak to what they see and what they don't see. What I can tell you, Brian, is the vote was made yesterday at the Law Society of Upper Canada here in Ontario, and it followed 2 days of argument and presentations by the benchers themselves. And I had the chance to watch some of it. And I was surprised at how many people disregarded what I believe to be the law, which would protect Trinity Western.
So how would the law protect Trinity Western students?
Well, what's interesting here and what's disappointing and even surprising is this is not a new issue. In 2001, our Supreme Court did examine Trinity Western's community covenant and did rule on it. In 2001, the British Columbia College of Teachers, which accredits teachers' colleges, refused to recognize Trinity Western graduates
as teachers. For the same reason?
For the same reason. The basis of their refusal was the community covenant and specifically the sections dealing with sex outside of the confines of biblical marriage. And the Supreme Court of Canada said, you can't do that unless you can demonstrate that Trinity Western graduates are somehow discriminating against their students, which of course they aren't and they weren't. You cannot do this. They have the right to exist. They have the right to freedom of religion. They have the right to freedom of association. And what's surprising and upsetting to someone like me who is a member of the Law Society of Upper Canada is that this vote yesterday happened after many people made these presentations.
So in Nova Scotia, they've just voted a couple of hours ago. They've just voted in the same thing. They voted for option C. It was 10-9. They won't recognize Trinity Western grads unless they're exempt from this community covenant. So Nova Scotia is not following the law either. In BC, they were accredited. That's now being challenged. So does Trinity Western have another recourse to the courts?
Yes.
Like are the law societies, are they, they're non-governmental bodies, their lawyers are a self-regulating group. do they have recourse to the courts to say, no, you've got to follow Supreme Court precedent here?
They do. So law societies are non-governmental bodies, but they are quasi-judicial bodies in the sense that they have authority delegated to them by the government. So the law societies have the authority to regulate the practice of law in their respective provinces. So that they are performing a government function or a quasi-government function. And as such, they're bound and required to adhere to the Charter of Rights and Freedoms, which protects freedom of religion, which ensures equality rights and equal treatment under the law on the basis of religion. So my prediction is that Trinity Western will challenge these decisions through the courts and that the courts will not ignore the law. They'll apply the law. And I would predict that ultimately this will be a success for Trinity Western.
Well, hopefully it is. Albertos, thanks for joining us today.